Hello everyone, and thank you for joining me. Today I'm going to be showing you how to make pigs in a blanket. All the ingredients and the measurements are listed down below, and we can start baking. The first thing we're going to do to make these is go ahead and mix up our dough, and that is going to start by blooming our yeast. So in the bowl of a stand mixer or a large mixing bowl, you go ahead and combine your yeast, a little bit of sugar, plus your water, which should be warmed just to a little over room temperature. You want it to be just slightly warm, but not so warm that if you touch it, it's going to feel hot. You just want it to feel a little bit warm. Go ahead and mix those together and then just let it sit for about 5 minutes so that the yeast can bloom. After about 5 minutes, your yeast should be nice and activated. It should smell like yeast at this point, and we can continue mixing our dough. So we're going to add in our milk, the rest of our sugar, our egg, flour, and salt. Now we're going to go ahead and put this onto our stand mixer with a hook attachment, and you're going to mix it on a medium-high speed for about 5 to 10 minutes. If you don't have a stand mixer, you can do this by hand, just kneading it until it comes together and then putting it out onto a flat surface and kneading it by hand for another few minutes until it has formed a nice solid ball. Now, after a few minutes, your dough should be nice and formed. It should pull away from the sides of the bowl. And at this point, we're going to start adding our butter. Now, you want your butter to be nice and soft so that it can work in very easily. And we're just going to add this to our dough about a tablespoon at a time. So you should go in about 3 or 4 additions to add in all of your butter. And just let your dough mix in between until the butter is completely incorporated. Once the butter is completely mixed in, all we're going to do is take the bowl off of our stand mixer, and we're going to go ahead and just get it off the hook, make sure that it forms a nice clean ball, and then we're going to go ahead and cover it up and let it rise until it is doubled in size. This should take anywhere from 1 to about 1.5 hours, depending on how warm your room is. Once your dough is rised, we are ready to pull it out and start shaving it around our little piggies. So you're going to go ahead and flour a surface, go ahead and turn your dough out, and then you're going to flour the top and then press it out into a nice flat rectangle. The size doesn't really matter at this point, just try and form a nice clean rectangle. Now what we are going to do is grab the little centers for our pigs in a blanket. I am using all beef hot dogs. You can go ahead and swap this out to whatever your preference is. If you want to switch it out for breakfast sausages or regular sausages, go right on ahead. Anything you want to be the center of your pigs in a blanket. Now, what we're going to do is cut our dough into about 1-inch strips, and you're going to go ahead and grab one of your little hot dog wieners, and you're going to start wrapping all the way from one side just in a nice round motion all the way to the other side. If the strip that you've cut off is too long, then all you're gonna have to do is go ahead and trim it towards the end. And then what I like to do is just take my wrapped up little hot dog and I like to roll it against the table just very lightly to make sure that the dough is completely adhered. Now you're going to keep on doing this with all your hot dogs or sausages until they are all nicely wrapped. If you do end up with a little bit of extra dough, then you can just go ahead and form this into a ball or any sort of loaf, and you can bake it off and just eat it as regular bread. I was able to make about 10 pigs in a blanket with this recipe, plus a few little baby carrots that I made for my vegetarian sister. Once all your pigs in a blanket are formed, we're going to go ahead and give it a nice little egg wash. This is just one egg that I've beaten up with a little bit of water. I like to brush it with egg wash before it starts proofing as well as before it goes into the oven. I think that egg washing it the first time keeps the dough from drying out while it rises. So just go ahead and take a pastry brush and just spread your egg wash nice all over your pigs in a blanket. Now you're going to go ahead and let your piggies rise until the dough is about doubled in size. This should take around 30 to 45 minutes. Once that has happened, we are going to wash them with our egg wash once again, and then we're going to put them into a 375 degree oven. Now we're just gonna go ahead and bake these until the outsides are nice and golden brown and shiny. Again, I did use hot dogs for this, which are pretty much already cooked. If you're using something like a sausage that has to be cooked through, then you might even want to cook these fully ahead of time and then wrap them as an already cooked sausage, just so you don't have to worry too much about your sausage not being done when your bread is fully cooked. Now, once your hot dogs are all ready, you can go ahead and pull them out of the oven and leave them to cool down. Once they are completely cooled, or while they are still warm, because it is a nice warm pig in a blanket, you can go ahead and eat them. I really love these with just a little bit of mustard. They are so, so tasty. I hope you make them, I hope you enjoy, and I'll see you next time.